Hello everyone, today we are going to start science chapter first, that is food, where does it come from? So six classes ready to start this chapter? See, before starting in this chapter, firstly look at these pictures. How many different varieties of foods are there? Yeah, so about all these things we will study, that in this chapter we will study what are the different sources of food. What are the different types of food which we are obtaining from plants and animals? And what are the food habits of humans and animals? Okay, so let us start with the chapter. Before that, some basic knowledge I want to give you. That if you see, in the morning, you wake up, you take breakfast, then you have lunch in noon time, you have dinner at night. Okay, you can say that food is just like a basic necessity for your body. As you require air and water, in the same way you require food. You can also analyze yourself, you can also observe it. If you are not taking food for 2 days, 2-3 days, what happens? You yourself start to feel unhealthy, you started to feel weak. Okay, so what we can say, that food has become a basic necessity for our body and we require it for doing any kind of work. We are walking, talking, seeing, writing, studying, whatever we are doing, for all that thing we require energy, and for that energy we require food. Okay, now people used to wonder that this much variety of food is there, then from where does this all food come from? Okay, this is about the chapter. So where does this all food come from? Actually, what happened in the earlier time, people used to go for traveling. Okay, people used to wander, people started traveling. So when they started traveling, they came to know about new types of plants and animals. Okay, when they came to know about new types of plants and animals, they developed different types of food. Okay, so if somebody asks how food get developed, so it get developed by traveling. When people started traveling, they came to know about different types of plants and animals, and now different types of foods were developed by those plants and animals products. Okay, today we can prepare many varieties of food, but at that time when the food was not known, then in this way the food was discovered. Okay, now come on the next heading of the chapter. What is this? That where does all this food come from? Okay, you think yourself that from where we are obtaining this much food. We are obtaining this food either from the plants or from the animals. Okay, its simple answer is this, that whatever food we are consuming, this is obtained either from the plants or from the animals. Okay, what we are obtaining it? We are obtaining the raw materials from the plants and animals. We want it, then we are cooking it, otherwise we are taking it as raw only. Okay, like mango is there. Just which fruit we are getting from the plant as mango, same in the same way we are taking. Otherwise, people are making mango juice or any other dishes of mango, so they are cooking it also. So we can say the raw materials which are obtained from the plants and animals can be taken in cooked form also, and it can be taken raw also. Okay, now one more point is there in the chapter, that is what is ingredients. See, whatever food you are taking, suppose you are taking a chocolate milk, okay? What you are taking? Suppose you are taking a chocolate milk. So for the preparation of chocolate milk, what do you need? You require milk, you require chocolate powder, yes, and you require sugar. So what things you require? Milk, chocolate powder, and the sugar. Okay, these are the ingredients for the preparation of chocolate milk. In the same way, whatever you are taking, suppose any vegetable is there which is being prepared at your home. So what things you require to make that vegetable, that are the ingredients of the food. Okay, that is the ingredient of that vegetable. Now, I told you that we are obtaining all the food either from the plants and from the animals. So in this chapter, we will study the same thing in some detail. Okay, but before that, one thing I want to tell you, that what are autotrophs and what are heterotrophs. See, Autotrophs are the green plants which make their own food by the process of photosynthesis. Okay, there are some green plants which are making their own food by the help of photosynthesis. They are known as autotrophs. Okay, and some other organisms who are dependent on others, they are not making their own food. They are known as heterotrophs. About this thing we will study in the next class in detail. Okay, so that's all for the day. Thank you everyone.